much different opinion than a family member or a close friend. Have you guys ever argued over that opinion? Well, it's no secret that today's society, the difference between Republicans and Democrats has never been more prevalent. One big topic that seems to come up in almost every conversation every day is gun control, an issue that neither side can really get grips on. Now, this topic means a lot to me because of how much it really means to the world and the United States as a whole. And gun control is not really a thing yet, but it's more an idea that Democrats would like to put in place. Now, many people have different opinions on what gun control is and what it would mean for the United States. So, according to Webster's Dictionary, gun control is defined as a set of laws or policies that limit the manufacture, sale, transfer, possession, and ownership of a firearm. In this speech today, gun control will be explained, examined, and seen in depth. And political parties aside, we will look at the darker side of gun control. Now, being that the Second Amendment is protected by the Constitution of the United States, the Second Amendment states a well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to bear arms shall not be infringed. Now, this is where a lot of controversy comes into play, because some people view that as, I can carry an assault weapon around wherever I want, I can do what I want with any gun that I want. And other people say that's not what the forefathers intended, and some say that the Constitution is so old that it should not be a credible source, yet over 2,000 years later we still follow the Bible. So, I don't really know. Now,
Is this supposed to be advancing?
No, not yet.
Okay.
So now I did some research on mass shootings, and what I found shocked even me. From August 1966 until now, only 809 people have been killed in a mass shooting being defined as a shooting with four or more deaths in the United States. That means that you are more likely to die from a shark attack, being executed, or being attacked by a dog in the United States. And those actually really surprised me. And the chances of you dying this year in a mass shooting are about 1 in 3 million. So I thought that was really surprising as well. Alright, so it's no secret that in today's world, media is more biased than it probably has ever been since the creation of media. It seems like today each news outlet has its own agenda and wants to present the news in whatever way they want. But how false is the news really? According to InfoWars, they published an article last year that said that MSNBC and CNN reportedly published over 23 different articles which contained false or misleading information about guns, leading viewers to lean left and be more against guns than for them. Also, with the most recent mass shooting in Florida, CNN used these two, David Hogue and Emma Gonzalez, as what they claim students at Parkland High School. This turned out to be false, and they were not actually students at Parkland. They just used them as a ploy to get people on board with gun control. Now, if you look at this up here, this is a news station from San Francisco. That is David Hogue over 2 months before the Parkland shooting, and he was accordingly a witness to a shooting in San Francisco. So my question is, if he was at Parkland 2 months later, how was he in San Francisco 2 months before it happened and a witness to a shooting? Because he said he lived in San Francisco during that news article. Now, how effective has gun control been in the past, you might ask? Well, in 1997, the UK decided to ban guns altogether. The results? According to the Research Center of Crime and Stats, stabbings went up nearly 400% in the UK. Armed robberies went up 52%, and gun homicides spiked over 35%. Also in 1997, Australia tried to follow in the UK's footsteps and implement the same system. However, their results were much deadlier. Rapes in Australia spiked over 340%. Home invasions soared up 3,000%. Yeah, I said that right, 3,000%. Gun homicides went up 270%, and overall crime in the country compared to the year before, went up 240%. Also, here in the U.S., Chicago is the city which has probably the strictest gun laws in America. So how's that working out for them? Well, last year alone, over 735 people lost their lives due to crime, and over 14,000 home invasions were reported. Historically speaking, every country that has tried to implement any type of gun control laws has not succeeded, and it has been devastating to the people that live there. Not to mention, in the past, Hitler, Stalin, Mao Zedong, and Kim Il-sung all stripped citizens of guns, and we saw how that worked out. So, the Dalai Lama once said, if someone has a gun and is trying to kill you, it makes reasonable sense that you shoot back with your own gun. Now listen up, given that gun control has proven non-trustworthy in the past, I don't see why the U.S. would lean towards that. I do, however, agree with safer background checks, checking into mental health more so than stripping guns themselves. I myself actually have this right here, which is a license to carry a handgun in public, and I carry my handgun in public on me, and it's always concealed. I carry it because if it ever came down to it, I would like to be able to protect myself and the people around me. And I would never leave my handgun, I would never take it out of the holster if I was not in a dire situation where I would ever need to do that. And I've been shooting guns since I was 7. My parents taught me gun safety from a very young age. And if they ever saw me do anything with a gun that was not safe or a safe manner in doing so, my father would have killed me. Actually killed me. So, there's that. Now, like I said before, Hitler, Stalin, and all the other terrible people that killed millions of people stripped their citizens of guns before committing terrible acts of violence against their people. Now, I'm not saying that this can happen in America, but what I am saying is if we give up our guns to the government, there's nothing from stopping criminals or the government from coming after us. And we could be involved in the next Holocaust. So I'm going to finish off with this. If America decides to strip us of our Second Amendment rights, which rights are next? Thank you.